Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Alpha Outdoors.
Well, we're here today at Jerusalem Mills, and we're going to take the gunpowder short loop today, and it seems like a beautiful day for it.
All right, well, come along, join us, and stay alpha.
First, leave the parking lot, you'll find yourself on a gravel trail. To your left are the woods, to the right, a large meadow. As you follow this trail, it will take you back to the entrance of the woods, where the real hike begins.
Tommy, get off that phone. Get off that phone, man.
Once you reach the entrance of the woods, you'll want to follow this trail back for a short distance. Eventually, you will come to a fork in the trail. Take the right path to follow the blue trail.
Thomas.
Alpha, baby.
Here with Thomas King of Alpha Outdoors.
Yeah.
Here in Jerusalem Mills. A little gunpowder fall.
Yeah, it's been a beautiful day out here hiking, I tell you.
Got much more to do.
Oh yeah. It's getting started.
Yeah, so far it's been a pretty decent trail. A lot of rocks and roots. So if you're not very mobile, maybe not the best trail for you. Otherwise, pretty easy to navigate. What say you, Tom?
Yeah, that's a pretty good one, man. Didn't have too much trouble for being a big fella.
A lot of down trees. It's very shaded though. Very nice on a hot summer's day. Get out here, enjoy some shade. By the end of the trail, we'll reach the water. So if it's really hot, take a dip. Should be good. Hiking shoes though. It's a little muddy throughout here. They're everywhere. Trees. A lot of birds out. Tell you what, Coast Lake, we've had a lot of cardinals this year. Like, it's been a huge uptick. At our house. I don't know if it's because there's less people out and about or
weather too.
Yeah. We had some cardinals build a nest right above our roof. A lot more vertical inclines than I expected, that's for sure.
Well, it's that elevation height is 384 feet.
That's not bad.
Up outdoors, baby.
Dead.
After a short hike through the woods, you eventually come to a nice sunny clearing. Find power lines running above your head.
I think we had a sunny patch, Tom.
Yes, we did. It's nice.
Time to get back in the shade, though.
Once clearing the sunny patch, you'll come back into the woods and find yourself at a three-way split. You no longer want to follow along the blue trail. Go left to take the white trail, down to the water.
So we've reached the point now where we are definitely by the water. I can hear it. And so we're going to go ahead and take you guys down there
and check it out.
Check it out. So we're still making our way down the white trail here. Getting pretty close to the water, as we said. So Tommy, what's your overall perspective on the little gunpowder trail so far?
I think it's pretty awesome. For being a short trail, you got a lot of elevation, you got a lot of, you got peaks, highs, low valleys. I mean, you got pretty much everything in a short trail. I like it.
Yeah, it's been great. The water's right down here. We're gonna go ahead and go take a look. This looks like it's off the beaten trail a little bit. But not so far it's not worth.
Yeah, it's very obvious that everybody comes down.
A lot of trash though, folks. Don't litter. Woo! She's a spinner. She's a spinner. Yes, we definitely reached the water here.
Step.
Anything biting? Yeah. Said he had one little nibble. Must be. You got any trout fishing tips for the public?
Yeah, power bait.
car really yet.
Power bay is the answer. You heard it here on Alpha Outdoors, folks. Smells delicious. And it tastes just like it smells.
All right, folks, we had our fun down here by the water. Time to get back on the white trail and continue our path.
All right, take us in.
Morning. Is it still morning? Yes. Oh, it most certainly is. Yeah.
Step out there if you'd like.
Definitely seems like a pretty good trout fishing spot.
Yeah. Thought it was gonna come off. Didn't it? Sorry, I get you. I was trying not to. Did you get smacked?
A little bit, I'm good.
Thomas just caught a branch to the face.
Yeah, you get down on the trails when you go with somebody else in front of you. Yeah.
Courtesy of me.
Yeah. Water's super clear, man.
Yeah, it's beautiful. I can't remember the last time I saw a creek this clear.
Thank you.
Yeah, we're still walking along the path here, the White Trail, down by the water now. It's been pretty exclusively by the water at this point. Looks like a great spot to trout fish.
Yeah, we got a whole bunch of trout fishermen down here.
Fishermen right over here right now. Seen at least a handful of them so far.
Yeah.
So, definitely a great place.
Mm-hmm.
So you definitely come out and check this place out.
Yeah, definitely.
Let it out. To put that one in the film. White Trail. On that damn phone.
Yeah, man. Make sure we're on track.
See, somebody tried to put some steps in here. Let's see if we can do this without falling like an idiot as we drink water and hold a camera. All right. A lot of roots, man. Goodness.
Site of ice pond depicted on 1860 map. Ice ponds were used to harvest ice prior to the invention of electric refrigerators and freezers. How about that?
Interesting stuff.
Yeah.
Dude, I love the hat, man. Legit.
He's an individual.
We got some more here. Want to step up in there and give us another history lesson?
It says here, site of waste gate used to shunt water from race back to river during flood conditions, thus lowering risk of damage to Jerusalem Mill downstream.
Some interesting little facts here on the trail.
Yeah. Got little relics over here. Ooh.
always serves well to follow the leader here, old trail guide Tom. Star of Alpha Outdoors.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, thank you if you've made it this far. We're about the end of the trail now here.
Yeah.
Head out and check out the
historical sites.
The historical sites, the Jerusalem Mill Village.
Yeah.
All right, hopefully you're still with us. If so, you're staying Alpha, baby.
Yeah, man.
All right, let's go.
Just about out of the White Trail here. That little gunpowder. Gonna finish the day up checking out the historical village that we told you about. Save the best for last, hopefully. Only one way to find out.
It looks like we're prohibited to go over there.
What would be over there? Just
buy some rapids or something.
Go down here and read this sign real quick. Make sure we don't break any rules.
Jerusalem Mill was constructed in 1772 and is now the centerpiece of the Living History Village. It was built by Isaiah Linton and David Lee. The village surrounding it functioned as a Quaker village into the early 20th century. Evidence suggests that David Lee and several of his Quaker neighbors carved black walnut stocks and assembled rifles for the Continental Army in the gun shop that stands behind the Grist Mill. In 1961, the state of Maryland purchased the property that included the mill, the blacksmith shop, and the stone building behind the mill for the Gunpowder Falls State Park. After the mill sat vacant for nearly 25 years, a handful of concerned local residents formed the nonprofit, all-volunteer Friends of Jerusalem Mill and embarked on a long journey to recapture the past. They saved the whole village, and the state rebuilt the mill as headquarters of the park and used program open space funding to purchase the rest of the original buildings. Jerusalem is now one of the most intact historical mill villages in Maryland.
Here at the historical Jerusalem Mills site, established in 1772, it says here, by David Lee, a Quaker. Let's take a little walk around and check out some of the sites.
Following the trail back behind the Miller's house, you'll see a sign that will lead you to the Percy Lee Bank Barn. Cross the bridge and follow the trail back through the woods to find where the old dairy farm foundation is at.
State sport right here.
Jousting, baby.
Yep, state sport jousting.
How we do it in Maryland.
I think we should go back to the medieval way, but...
Me too, baby. That's alpha.
Following the trail along the jousting fields that leads from the Dairy Farm Foundation, you will find yourself emptying out on Jericho Road. And this is where you will find the Jericho Covered Bridge. Jericho Covered Bridge was constructed in 1865 across the Little Gunpowder Falls. The bridge is 88 feet long, 14.7 feet wide, and open to traffic. Thank you.
a sucker for bridges, Tom.
So good. How long was it going, Pat? 30 minutes?
Not sure. Huh? I'm gonna check out this rock face over here. Tommy's already over there checking it out.
Pretty good rock face over here. Nice washout. Watch
yourself. Yeah.
It's easy to fall backwards.
Oh, no doubt. Yeah, it's like cut out in there, man.
Yeah.
That's pretty sweet.
Yeah, it's very unstable. Like that one rock right there is getting ready to go if that thing goes.
Oh, yeah. It's the last piece of the puzzle, ready to fall out.
That would suck.
No doubt.
That is one rock holding all that together, man. That's crazy.
If you have made it this far in the video, you are truly a part of the Alpha Empire, baby. Remember to always stay alpha. Ooh, baby. You didn't go over in here? You didn't go over up in here? Boy. I'll tell you what, I need to come back here with a guitar.
All right.
Happening, Alpha Empire. We're going to test this hole here to see how deep it is. See whether or not I want to jump off of it.
I'm gonna
false it.
Stand straight up.
Nope.
Hey, deep.
Not deep enough. It is definitely deceiving.
Yep.
Yeah. Well, so much for that. You guys missed out on an opportunity.
It's only like a foot. Yeah.
It looks deeper up here, man.
Yeah, but I saw it from over there. I'm like, yeah, let's check it.
Oh, well.
Yeah. All right.
Would have been nice.
Our journey is coming to a close here. We did quite a lot of walking today.
Right. It was a nice walk.
Oh yeah.
Nice hike today. It says it was only a 2 mile hike, but I'm pretty sure we probably did about 4.
Oh, I know I did. Go ahead, Tom. Back to the Jerusalem Village. And they even have a walking trail or a walking bridge. Thank you. Yeah, they got wood just chopped up down there ready for people to burn. It's legitimate. Maybe. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining Alpha Outdoors. We appreciate your support. Hit that like and subscribe button.
Yeah, and always stay alpha.
Stay alpha, baby. We'll put GPS coordinates in the description so you can find out how to get here yourself and explore. This has been Alpha Outdoors, Kings Conquering the Earth, Jerusalem Mills, Little Gunpowder Falls Trail.
Signing off.